Good afternoon, students. I welcome you all, the MCOM second semester research methodology subject students, for the lesson number 42. The topic is research in commerce and management. I am your teacher, Dr. K.V. Somnath, G.S. College of Commerce, Wardha, Maharashtra. Let us go for the introduction. The research conducted in commerce and management is also denoted as business research. Business research is described as the systematic and objective procedure for producing information, for help in making business decisions. Business research should be objective, which means that the information found needs to be detached and impersonal instead of biased. Research facilitates the managerial decision process for all aspects of a business. By lowering the uncertainty of decisions, it cuts down the risk of making incorrect decisions. Research should be an aid to managerial judgment, but not for a replacement for it. Now, let us go for the discussion of the scope of business research. If you observe that business is a vast arena and which covers both the trade, commerce and industry. So now let us go for the view of the canvas of the scope for business research. Number one, production management. The research performs an important function in product development, diversification, introducing a new product, product improvement, process technologies, choosing a site or new investment, etc. In the case of the personnel management, research works well for job redesign, organization restructuring, development of motivational strategies and organizational development. Means the personnel management is now being shaped into human resource management. Now marketing management. Research performs an important part in choice and size of target market, the consumer behavior with regards to attitudes, lifestyles and influences of the target market. It is the primary tool in determining price policy, selection of channels of distribution and development of sales strategies, product mix and promotional strategies, etc. In the case of the financial management, research can be useful for portfolio management, distribution of dividend, capital raising, hedging and looking after fluctuations in foreign currency and product cycles. In the materials management, it is utilized in choosing the supplier, making the decisions relevant to make or buy, as well as in selecting negotiation strategies. In the case of general management, it contributes greatly in developing the standards, objectives, long-term goals and growth strategies. To perform well in a complex environment of business, we will have to be equipped with an understanding of scientific methods and a way of integrating them into decision making. We will have to understand what good research means and how to conduct it. Since the complexity of business environment has amplified, there is a commensurate rise in the number and power of the instruments to carry out research. There is certainly more knowledge in all areas of management. We now have started to develop much more better theories. The computer has provided us a quantum leap in the capability to take care of difficulties. New techniques of quantitative analysis utilize this power. Communication and measurement techniques have also been improved. These developments reinforce each other and are having a substantial impact on the business management and the business environment. The business research assists decision makers shift from intuitive information gathering to organized and objective study. Even though researchers in different functional fields may examine different phenomena, they are comparable to each other simply because they make use of similar research techniques. Research is the fountain of knowledge for the sake of knowledge, and it is a crucial source of providing guidelines for solving various business issues. Thus, we can say that the scope of business research is enormous, extensive. Now, let us go for the observation of the various purposes of doing business research. The first and foremost thing is understanding the market trend. Second, evaluate the business efforts. Third one is understand the needs of customers. Fourth one is discover the problem areas of business. Fifth one is identify new business opportunities. Set targets for business growth, analyze the competitiveness of goods and services. So you can start at any point of the research as shown in the figure, and you can derive ultimately the main objectives and purpose doing the behind the business research. Now the scope. Merger, bank mergers, bankruptcy, brand awareness, competitive intelligence, consumer loyalty, consumer risk, copycat products, corporate crime, corporate culture, corporate social responsibility, customer competencies, data security, downtown revitalization, employee coaching, franchises, green products, industry disruptors, intellectual capital, job sculpting, marketing ethics, mergers, organic graphs, outsourcing, philanthropy, quality circles, regional planning, risk management, service initiatives, shared service model, short-term financing, Starbucks effort, strategic planning strikes, subliminal advertising, telemarketing, underage workers, underrating undocumented workers, unions, visual blowing, organizations, work ethics, work-life balance, workplace diversity, and much more. So many areas are there for, particularly in the business research. Now, let us go for the observation of some topics in the management and administration area. Bias in production, core competencies, dress code, downsizing, employee benefit planning, employment equity, flexible scheduling, glass ceiling, harassment, human resources, knowledge management, labor disputes, mentoring, public unions, reverse performance evaluation, sexual harassment, strategic human resource management, succession management, team leadership, telecommuting, total quality management, trans-partnership, troubled employees, workplace atmosphere, workplace violence, and work from home. These are some of the topics we can have a scope to go for research in the management and administration area. Now let us go for some of the topics in the economics area too, because commerce and management have been derived from the mother subject, that is economics only. Henceforth, this also can be considered as a part of the business research. They are austerity measures, bailout, Bitcoin, consumerism, credit crisis, currency manipulation, demonetization, depression, econometrics, economic stimulus approaches, exchange rates, farm subsidies, bank interest rate, GST, forecasting, foreign exchange, green economy, informal economy, minimum wage, national debt, prevailing wage laws, recession, sharing tariffs, unemployment, world economy, and so on and so forth. With this, I thank all of you, and I request you to go at least 2 to 3 times across this video lesson and try to own way of manipulating the things by observing what has been discussed in the name of various topics issued and discussed in this particular video. And I hope you will stay better, stay safe, and stay protected, and you will read better, you will learn better. I hope, once again, I request you to go through this lesson as many times as possible, because we are the students of commerce and management, and there is a vast arena, and that too in the present day dynamic environment of the world economic scenario, we need to have much more exposure on the related issues where we can go for conduct of research. Till then, stay safe and stay protected. Thank you. Thank you very much. All the best.